Listening Library presents Max and the Midknights, Book 2, Battle of the Bodkins, by Lincoln Peirce. Read for you by a full cast.
Chapter 1. I think Sir Brickbat hates me.
No, 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 Max. You're doing it all wrong.
We've been practicing our sword fighting skills for 3 hours now, and he's been yelling the whole time, mostly at yours truly. The question is, why? I mean, it's not like I'm the worst one here. Some of these kids can't tell a sword from a salami. But whenever our fearless leader wants to air out his tonsils, I'm his favorite target.
Max, hold your hands higher. Or are you too tired?
I'm not tired.
Is that so? Then there's no excuse for your poor technique.
What? My technique's just fine. Our instructor's the problem. Not that I'd ever say that out loud. At KSB, Knight School of Bijovia, the most important lesson isn't sword fighting or archery. It's keeping your eyes open and your mouth shut.
Here's an idea. Sedgwick will show you how it's done.
Ugh, couldn't someone else show me how it's done? Of all the first years in the class, Sedgwick's the most annoying. It's not that he's a bad student. Just the opposite. He's good. Really good. That's what's so obnoxious about him.
You called for me, Sir Brickbat?
Indeed I did. Spar with Max here. Show her how it's done. And go easy, Sedgwick. Remember, she's only a girl.
Only a girl? I feel my cheeks burning as Sir Brickbat's words hang in the air. I could tell he didn't like me, and now I know why. He thinks only boys should be knights. If it were up to him, I wouldn't even be here.
Ready, Max?
I'm ready, Sedgwick. And hey, forget that stuff about going easy. Give me your best.
I don't know if I...
And duel.
Just so you know, we're not using real weapons. These are training swords. They're made of steel, but the blades have rounded edges, so nobody accidentally loses an arm. It's a safety thing. But safe or not, it still doesn't feel very good to get whacked by a big hunk of metal. Oof! Like that.
Oh, sorry, Max. Can I help you up?
No. Even if I did need any help, I wouldn't take it. I can't let everybody think I'm not knight material. I drag myself off the ground, ready for Max versus Sedgwick round 2. And this time, he's going down!
That's enough for today. Class dismissed. Except for you, girl. You're staying.
What for?
I need someone to take these rocks here and move them to that wall over there.
Are you serious?
Oh, I'm serious. But are you?
What do you mean?
If you really want to be a knight, you have to build up your strength.
Yeah, but...
Move the rocks, then you're free to go.
Welcome to another day in paradise. Pretty glamorous, huh? I figured training to become a knight would be a lot of work, but not this kind of work. Knight school wasn't always such a drag. Actually, when I enrolled here only a month ago, it was great. Old Brickbud wasn't our teacher back then. Sir Gadabout was in charge. Gadabout used to be the commander of the Royal Guard. The guy's a legend. He's as old as these rocks and twice as tough. But you know the best thing about him? He's an awesome teacher. Or he was. We'd had maybe 6 or 7 days of classes when a special visitor arrived at the school. King Conrad. He and Gadabout spoke privately. The very next day, Gadabout was gone. That's when this Brickbat clown showed up to take over. Since then, KSB has been pretty rocky. Rocky! Get it? Actually, oof. These are more like boulders.
Max?
Millie!
Hi!
If you don't know who Millie is, I'll keep this short. She's one of my best friends, and she's a Midknight. Wondering who the Midknights are? It would take a whole book to tell that story.
Max, what are you doing with those stones?
Besides getting some honkin' blisters on my hands, not much. Just doing some heavy lifting for the world's worst sword-fighting teacher.
Want some help?
Sure, I'd love some. But even with two of us, this job will take hours.
Maybe, or maybe not.
Wow! Did I forget to mention that Millie has magical powers? That's sort of an important detail. With just a wave of her wand, she moved the whole pile. Millie, you're like a genuine sorceress now.
No, I've still got a long way to go. But I'm learning a lot from Mumblin. He's a really good teacher.
Obvious fact of the day. Mumblin is a wizard. And not some average, everyday wizard either. He was once by Jovia's royal magician. That was way back in the day, though. By the time Millie and I met him, he was a bit of a mess. Mumblin once accidentally changed my uncle into a goose. That was one of his better spells. But here's the twist. The old guy wasn't completely washed up after all. When the chips were down, he delivered some pretty clutch magic. And he's definitely doing a great job of showing Millie the ropes. That must be nice, Millie.
What?
Having a good teacher.
I'm sure Brickbat's not all bad.
Actually, he's pretty much all bad.
Hey, you girls, stop standing around. Max, aren't you supposed to be moving rocks?
Rocks. Rocks. Oh, you mean those rocks by the wall?
That? No, what?
He's speechless.
An added bonus. Sir Brickbat is staring slack-jawed at the stone skyscraper we made, and Millie turns to me as we leave the training yard.
Now we can do something fun.
What's more fun than punking Sir Brickbat?
I think we should see what Kevin is up to.
Great idea.
Super! Let's go.
Kevin's a Midknight, just like me and Millie. He's the first person I met when I came to Bijovia. And he also happens to be a total genius. We head for his house, and as we make our way through the streets, a lot of people stop us along the way.
Greetings, Sir Max.
Hi.
Bless you, Sir Max.
And same to you.
Max, do you ever get tired of people thanking you for saving Bijovia?
I mean, we, not just me. We all saved Bijovia.
The rest of us helped, it's true, but it wouldn't have happened without...
Kevin!
Max! Millie! Hello! Your timing is superb. You've arrived at the precise moment of the grand opening.
Of what?
Read the sign. It explains everything.
Kevin's Jolly Good Library. A library! Kevin! That's wonderful!
Yeah, absolutely! What is a library?
An archive of books, open to the public. Anyone can visit the library and borrow books free of charge.
How many books are in your library?
One! But if I may be so bold, it's quite a book. Here it is.
Hey, that's us on the cover! The Tale of Max and the Midknights by Kevin.
Yes! It's the entire story of our thrilling adventure, commencing with the auspicious day we met and concluding with King Conrad's triumphant return to the throne.
Kevin, it's beautiful. I love all the drawings inside.
Me too.
This one of Simon really looks like him.
Ooh, let me see. I want to make sure you drew me handsome enough.
Simon!
I say, this is smashing. All four Midknights together again.
Simon gets a hearty handshake from Kevin and a hug from Millie. Then he walks over.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.